Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to work on ET15000, and my intention is to do an uncasing video, but I forgot we already took the side panel off and we took the printhead off, so you might have to check over previous videos. Again, the video is shot in lab, there'll be some noises.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. I'm going to show how to remove the FFC cables in this ET15000 printer. I already took off one side panel so I could access the FFC cables and the one wire that is connected with the scanner. I detached them from the main board and now I'm moving over to the other side panel. And I'm going to go ahead and remove the screws from there. There's one screw on the top and the back on the side panel. And then there's going to be another screw covering up where the waste tank is. This screw is different. It's a flathead screwdriver, so you'll want to switch it out. It's a little bit harder to take out, so if you push in on that cover while you screw or unscrew it out, it makes it a little bit easier, and then you can just pop off that cover. It shows that there's an area for a screw here, but this did not have a screw in it. I was able just to pull it out, but if yours has a screw, just unscrew it and then take out your waste tank. Once you do that, you'll look to see if there's any other screws, and there's one screw down on the bottom of this side panel like there was on the other side. Take that screw out and hold on to it to put it back together later, and then you can remove this side panel. Now we have this upper rear cover and screw under that. Once you take that screw out, you can lift up on this back rear cover, and it takes a little bit of a jiggle to finagle it out. There might be a little bit of a tab on the other side that you're trying to wiggle it out of, so it was easier for me to just turn the whole printer around backwards and put my hand on both sides to just try to lift up and out, push it forward and lift out. On another printer, it has more of, once you take that one screw out, on ST2000s, it has a similar rear back piece. You take that screw out and then you push forward and then lift up. Push forward as in push forward to the left side of the printer and it pops out. Once we have that part taken off, we just need to take off that blue support system by twisting it to the scanner and then just move the printer over to the left and it should come off the hinges. We have full access and working space to the printhead now in the carriage area. So I'm working on taking out the damper holder. There's two tabs on either side. I'm using a little pin to push the tabs in and lift out. And I already have taken the dampers out of there. So once that's out of the way, I can use my drill to take out the three screws that hold the printhead in place. And there's going to be one large FFC cable that goes to the printhead and under it. So I can take a pair of pliers and grab the printhead, lift it up and out, and that will reveal that large FFC cable under on the bottom. I can take that piece out, and now my printhead's gone. My big FFC cable is open, and I'm going to go ahead and use my fingers to push out the FFC cables that are put in this small opening on the side of the carriage to hold your FFC cables in place. Then there's going to be two smaller FFC cables, one leading on the back side of the carriage to the CR sensor, and then one onto the bottom. The next thing I want to work on is taking out these screws that are onto the mainframe that hold onto this PSD assembly. It'll be easier for me to take that off and be able to then take off that rail clip or the FFC clip that's holding it to the rail. But besides that, it will be easier for me to then remove the FFC cables altogether because there is double-sided tape on the FFC cables sticking to the back of the rail. So I do need to be able to move that to take off the double-sided tape. So I have the printer turned around backwards now, and I have detached one of the cables, and then I'm going to detach another cable, and that's where I'm then going to take out the two FFC cables, the larger ones that lead to the printhead. I did have to remove some of the smaller FFC cables that I'm not actually taking out just to have better access to what I'm trying to reach. I'll take a mental note as to where those go so I can put them back when I replace the FFC cables later. But you'll see that some of these red and black wires do a little bit of weaving in and out of this white PSD assembly. So I'm just moving those out of the way. Now here is where I'm trying to remove the rail clip, that FFC clip. I had to push from behind a little bit once I already moved that front tab, pushed it up. I didn't want to break the clip off or the tab off of the clip. So with my other hand, you see I'm pulling that clip forward while pushing with that metal pin the tabs out of that locking position from the metal rail. And while I'm pushing from behind, I'm also trying to push the rail clip and the FFC cables to the right to try to pop it out. And once I do, I can then take that rail clip off. And there it is. I'll show it to you closer. But I just wanted to pop it out while pushing to the one way and from behind. Once I have that, then I just use my little screwdriver to push in on some of the white tabs from the PSD assembly, and then I can pop it in the direction that the tabs, like the opposite direction of the tabs. So once those tabs are pushed in from the main rail, you push in the opposite direction, which is basically the same thing I did with that black rail clip or the FFC clip. I just did the same thing with the PSD assembly. So now that's off. Now you see here's where I'm pulling that double-sided tape, so I needed the space to do that. I found that it was easier for me to fold the side of the FFC cable leading to the printhead and then pull that through the rail leading to the main board, and that would take my FFC cables out. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please visit us at bchtechnologies.com, or you can visit us locally in Greensboro, North Carolina. Happy printing, everyone. That's how you take out the FFC cables.